Hello everyone, my name is Essence Sauls and this is Alex Box, and today we're going to be discussing the similarities and differences of Nike and Adidas, and they are two of the most successful footwear, apparel, and equipment companies. And for a brief overview, we will discuss four phases, being the company's history, products, corporate culture, and CSR reports. And to conclude, we will decide which company we feel is better managed. I had Adidas, and Adidas was created on August 18, 1949 by Adi Dassler and his brother Adolf Dassler. Rudolf Dassler departed from the company early on and created his own, which is named Puma. But the primary focus of the company was to create a soccer shoe that would provide comfort and stability for athletes and enhance their performance. And later in 1997, they partnered with Reebok to expand their company.
And for Nike, the future CEO of Nike, AKA Phil Knight, as you heard before, he initially went to the University of Oregon to run track and met Bill Bowerman in 1957. And soon after noticing that Bowerman dabbled in creating shoe designs with the waffle iron to create the traction in the shoes, which I found really interesting. It led to the two pairing up and creating Blue Ribbon Sports in 1962 and partnering with the Onitsuka Tiger Company in Japan. And after, around 1963, they supplied revenue about 8,000 that year, just selling the shoe and Knight's car and whatnot. And the following year after that, they decided to change their name to Nike. And I also found it really interesting that currently today, their mission statement is anyone who has a body is considered an athlete. So they're really striving to push towards everyone being a part of the Nike family and having Nike shoes. And really interesting that they only have a little over 900 stores worldwide, and they're considered one of the most popular brands. Now, as far as products go, Nike has a wide variety of products that are pretty popular with their Nike or Roshe line, as you can see right here with the Roshe. They can be customized to see fit, mainly with the Nike line. So if you don't like, say, a purple on the shoe, you can get your red shoe. And they pretty much have shoes that are sponsored that has the name of an athlete on in every single category, basketball, soccer, golf. So pretty much, most are popular. I found that it was very interesting that the marketing strategy was to implement these popular athletes' names, like Kobe Bryant, LeBron James, Kevin Durant. They even started a shoe line for Carmelo Anthony and Blake Griffin in order to draw in their fans to their shoe line, and which created a lot of popularity for Nike. But they're by far the most popular shoe line, in my opinion, is the Jordan shoe line, with the Air Jordans probably being the most popular, as said in class before, to the point where people's lives are at risk. So take it or leave it in a positive manner or not, Nike has done something right with their product line and being able to make them well demanded like that.
Similar to Nike, Adidas also does a good job in promoting their shoes and getting endorsements from celebrities and athletes. A large amount of their profit comes from footwear, specifically soccer cleats and regular shoes. According to SoulCollector.com, the Stan Smith shoe, which is this shoe right here, it was marketed in 1973 and as of March 6, 2015, is the best-selling shoe. Both companies have very similar products. They both consist of casual, stylish, athletic, and training shoes. They have apparel and clothing. They have accessories, toiletries, and also sports and training equipment. And you can find them in the mall or any kind of athletic store. So, when discussing the corporate culture of Adidas, there was a big push of innovation and teamwork. And they believe that with the combination of strong leadership, employment engagement, and team spirit, then that's the way they can maximize their business. Looking into the company itself, the employees really enjoyed the working environment that was provided for them, but they didn't really like how hard it was to move up levels in the management.
And as far as Nike goes, they are considered really innovative and creative, and they pull in an audience or pull in a prospective pool of people who want to work there for that. And the main thing that I found that Nike really pushes with their company is leader engagement and everyone being engaged, and that they want you to do better in the company and whatnot. And I found that that created a sort of competitiveness, a positive competitiveness in the company, and a lot of people just love working there and the atmosphere there, with a 95% approval for the CEO currently. So Nike is pretty much also allows people on their campus to have activities such as relaxing, going to work out, have a happy hour, March Madness, etc. So I thought Nike was pretty good in that. And there was also instances of office or politics, but it didn't really harm what the employees had to say. As far as Nike's CSR goes, they used to be one of the worst, especially in the 90s, with being caught with child labor, they were considered to have terrible CSR because of that. And in around 1998, Nike proposed that they were going to make change in the company. And around 2005, Nike was actually considered to be one of the first transparent companies in their industry. So I found that really interesting how a company's turned like that. And they actually partnered with Swiss company Blue Sign Technologies in order to accelerate the supply of sustainable material, a fly knit that was said before, in order to decrease their environmental footprint and decrease their usage of decrease their waste. And I found it interesting that their latest CSR report was in 2012 and 13. And before that, it was 08 to 09. So they're pretty stagnant on their releasing their CSR reports, and they deemed to give some results in that latest CSR report that I don't exactly know yet, without going on the website Nike Responsibility, which they sort of explained their main CSR points. And I found it also found it interesting that they also, with the recent crash of their factory in Bangladesh, they were under fire for that, for being also a little part of it. And they said that they wanted to push safety for it, but they also seemed that it wouldn't fit their budget, like it wasn't affordable enough. So they also had some issues there, so it led me to believe that there is a little less transparency, at least now, than what they say in their CSR reports. And this also leads me to believe that their CSR report is done by their marketing team, because it seems like they really are trying to hit buzzwords that would resonate with the audience or the consumers.
On the other hand, Adidas CSR report was written, the latest one was 2014-2015. And in there, it contains a variety of different issues and challenges that are faced by the company and the shareholders, and possible solutions. And they stress a great deal of sustainable materials. And in their CSR report, it's broken into two sections, the people section and the product section. Each section provides education on how sports can be beneficial to helping personal development and also contributing to a better society. When comparing both CSRs, unlike Adidas, Nike's was outdated. The most recent one was 2012 to 2013, so there's no way to see what they're up to now, which can be seen as a weakness in the company. Adidas, you can tell because of their determination, their passion about getting presenting the issues and trying to find solutions and trying to do better for the environment. You can tell that it was written by their management team, whereas Nike was. In their CSR report is showing all that they've done. They want everybody to know they're being like really prideful, boastful, and like kind of cocky about it. So you can tell that their CSR is written by their management team, the marketing team.
And in conclusion, we came to the conclusion that we believe that both companies are pretty even. Whereas Nike boomed and probably is way more popular than Adidas currently. Adidas is sort of gaining traction back into that industry, and they're also succeeding in what Nike is lacking, such as their CSR, and their company culture is a little bit more loved, as it seems, with Adidas employees, but as well as Nike's. So I found that really interesting. It was a tough decision to come down to it because both companies initially are probably the two biggest companies in the whole world as far as this industry, and so we found it